The Sustainable Sites Credit category in LEED version 4.1 rewards decisions about the environment surrounding the building. It emphasizes the vital relationships among buildings, ecosystems, and ecosystem services. I'm Karima Salim, and I work in the LEED Technical Development Department of the U.S. Green Building Council on the Location and Transportation and Sustainable Sites Credit categories. We've spent the last several years looking at real LEED projects to see what's working well and what can continue to improve. Now we're excited to share the evolution of our design and construction rating systems under LEED version 4.1. Let's walk through what to expect from these credits. LEED system goals explain what LEED aims to achieve. The concepts within the Sustainable Sites credit category touch on many of these goals. In particular, protect and restore water resources and protect and enhance biodiversity and ecosystem services. LEED v4.1 is an incremental update to the rating system. We wanted this rating system to be more accessible than ever so that more projects are able to restore site elements, integrate the site with local and regional ecosystems, and preserve the biodiversity that natural systems rely on. Here is the full list of prerequisites and credits in the Sustainable Sites credit category in LEED version 4.1 for building, design, and construction. Let's review some of the highlights in LEED version 4.1. Perhaps the most exciting updates are to the rainwater management credit. First, we reduced all the thresholds of the required percentile reductions. We think these revised thresholds will be more realistic for project teams in different climate zones, while still honoring the credit intent. Along with the new thresholds, we've clarified acceptable low-impact development techniques. A common question about Option 2 of the Heat Island Reduction Credit was whether calculations needed to include off-street parking. LEED version 4.1 clarifies that off-street parking does need to be included. Another common source of confusion was roof spaces that are used by people, such as roof decks, recreational courts, and helipads. Since these spaces are functional for occupants, they can be excluded from the roof calculations, and instead counted under the non-roof portion of the credit. The Protect or Restore Habitat credit has been improved in a number of ways. We've adjusted the percentage of soil that needed to be restored from 30% to 25% to make it more accessible to all project teams. We've also updated the soil testing requirements to clarify that only imported soils need to be tested, not existing soils. And we've added a new vegetation section that aligns with the site's version 2 rating system. We've also revised Option 2 of this credit to make it more accessible. LEED version 4.1 integrates several new resources that will be helpful to project teams. The Heat Island Reduction Credit now references the Cool Roof Rating Council's Rapid Ratings Program. This resource can help provide guidance applicable to projects across the globe. The Site Assessment Credit now requires a description of the project's EPA Level 3 ecoregion. This description will help project teams fulfill a number of other credit requirements in this category. Finally, we added more examples of low-impact development techniques to the Rainwater Management Credit, including reference standards that go into great detail. We're excited about the new opportunities that the Sustainable Sites credit category includes. We hope that projects will be better able to use these strategies to increase the performance of their project sites.